What exactly is consumer surplus? Suppose I want a computer, because it gives me a happiness of $700. I go to the market and realize I can buy it at just $500. Whoa, $200 of net happiness. This is my consumer surplus. On the demand curve, though everyone pays the same price at $500, different consumers have different willingness to pay. I'm willing to get the computer at $700. It costs only $500. My surplus is $200. Then another guy is willing to pay $600. His surplus is lower at $100. And of course, you have a guy who's only willing to pay $500. His surplus is zero. What about a guy who's willing to pay $400? The computer costs $500. No transaction will take place. Add up all these surpluses. This is the total consumer surplus in the market. What about producer surplus? Suppose I produce computers. I want to sell each of these at $300. I go to the market and realize that everyone else is selling these at $500. Happily, I price my computer at $500, which is cool. I'm expecting $300, but I get $500. That's $200 extra. On the supply curve, though everyone sells at an equilibrium price of $500, different producers have different willingness to sell. I hope to sell my computer for at least $300. Sold it at $500. My producer's surplus is $200. Another guy wants to sell his computer at $400. His surplus will be lower at $100. For a guy who wants to sell his computer at $500, his producer surplus is zero. Add up all the producer surplus and you get a triangle area. Add up these two triangles, we have the total surplus, also known as the social welfare. All of us know that this is the market equilibrium point. Do you know this is also the allocatively efficient point? Check out the next video on allocative efficiency. If you like this video, remember to like and subscribe.